We are coming to you from Talladega Super Speedway for the Camper World Trucks Full Throttle 250K. I am your host, Pacey Toast. Along with me is Bobby, Revan, Freddie Gucci, and Waffle Jr.
It's your boy.
And the pace car will roll on off, and here we go. Starting on the pole will be in the 14 is Stephen Rea alongside Ariadne in the 11.
In row number 2, we have John Barry in the 4 Haviland truck alongside Bobby Chaney.
And the 3rd row on the outside of the 54 Nick Miller on to the outside will be Alex, a name I can't pronounce. Charmaine, I guess? I don't know.
In row 4, we got the number 15 Femi Ulan and the number 17 Stuart Redman.
We got here row number 5 with Corey Lemons and Ryan Merritt.
And starting just outside the top 10 will be the number 92 of Hunter Combs. On his outside will be Freddie De La Rosa.
And in row number 7, we got that SpongeBob number 15, Jared Darling, alongside Nathan Duanis.
And the 8th row would be the 20 of Bobby Siski and the other Haviland car. And the 13 would be Derek Barre.
In row number 9, we got the number 2 of Marcus Richardson and the number 33 of Matt Sinsford.
And finally, we got your boy, your local Asian gangster, Nick Holzbeck. A V8 upgrade from a V6 Mustang all the way to a C5 Corvette, so congratulations to him.
Oh god.
60 laps will be the distance here at Talladega. These are all drivers from the Full Throttle Racing League, NORC, and the SRA Sim Racing Authority League. 19 starters will be taking the green flag. Everybody will have 3 resets. Should be a great, great race. The drafting model for the trucks is absolutely insane. So we should see a great race. Pace car is going to pull off Stephen Rea and that Ream number 14 truck is outside Ariadne. Here they come. It's a long way down to this start-finish line. Nice pace car right there. And green is waiting.
Boogity,
and
boogity, boogity, let's
green
go
flag
racing.
Is out. Green, green, green here at Talladega.
As they head off into turn 1, they're double file. Looks like someone trying to pull them to make it 3 wide already.
And it did not take long for these boys to go 3 wide. See Bobby Chaney pull to the outside, Stephen Rea on the inside there with Revan all over his back bumper.
They're going 3 wide all out already. The number 22 and number 11 trucks already hooking up.
Yeah, they got a great run of that outside.
They're kind of got some moving around going on. We're already 3 wide already. Several rows already. Big pack of cars right here.
Yeah, this can't be good. This can't last for long, at least for now.
Looks like no one picking back to being double foul when they are.
Business is already picked up, boys.
This is just completing lap 1 of 60, and Ariadne will lead the first lap here at Talladega.
Looks like the outside line is going to speed, but the 11 is going to pull down, bringing, I believe, the 22 down with them as they pull up down the bottom line here.
At Talladega, you'll see tons of lead changes here, tons of 3 wide racing. One little mistake can be really big in a track like this and the racing like this.
Yeah, speaking of mistakes, Bobby Chaney started 4th. He's all the way in the dead last now after making that out move to make it 3 wide.
And the good thing about these races, though, you can easily work your way through the field. You know, if you get back, you can get right back up there. And as we saw, Freddie, who started near the back, is already near the top 5. Look at that.
Bobby Chaney up into the back, my little thing, he's saving his stuff for now. All these drivers, they have 3 resets. You might think it's a lot, but...
Alrighty, this is it.
Oh, did they save it?
Look at Hunter down there in the grass. Oh my gosh, they saved that. Unbelievable. That's incredible.
Great work,
Fred
De La Rosa, right there. Great
no,
work.
Cool thing. This driver, they had 3 resets, but they can go really quick here, as we saw just right now.
Looks like the 14 car has got a little push from the 19. Looks like they're trying to get them later, side by side up here from front.
And you see here, just double foul after that very close call. I don't know how they saved it back there over off turn 2, but Ariadne led the first lap. He's going to lead another one here, side by side for the lead.
See the field spread out a little bit here. Might be good for the green flag.
It's only lap three.
Yeah, man. We got two rows of four, or we got, you know, two lines of four right here. We see we got a group of four behind them trying to catch up and make it a 12-car pack.
See the 19 truck struggling to hold a line. Might be a lot of drivers here complain about that coming soon.
Yeah, if you don't have like a perfect line around this racetrack, people will go around you really quickly because they're going to be able to trust you to hold a good line and not cause a wreck.
Yeah, a little spread out here, but some still. Look at three wide racing. Femi looking to the outside with Bobby Zielinski behind him. No. 19 kind of in the sucker hole there.
That looks like they might be four wide up here. For the
yes, they. Oh, no. Three. Oh, yeah, they are four wide. This
is not very smart, though.
Yep, no. Femi's going to go with the 19, and oh, man.
Got to hold
really
your
close.
Line, man.
Still four wide.
This is going in badly. This is
and,
going in badly.
There we go.
That car's up into the wall.
And oh,
go,
that oh my god, that 20 hit really hard.
That looks
yeah,
like we might have car upside down back here.
They are still wrecking.
Camera shot wasn't that. All that great. That will be the first caution of the race.
Caution number one here. It's Talladega. It's a pretty nasty crash. These guys in a big pack, you know, just one little mistake, and this is the stuff you'll see. Let's take a look here. Like we said, four wide, and you got to be really careful.
Yeah, man, there's enough space, but let's see what happened. Oh, looks like Femi neck-hoed him a little bit, but he came down.
And a couple of Toyota Tundras getting together there, the 11 and the 16. And
Oh,
wow, what a hit for the 11. Look at the 20 shooting down there, guys.
What a crash.
There's a,
and then he gets hit again.
What a free-for-all.
Man, who didn't get in this crash?
We see Cody Lamas down there, and the 14, our pole sitter, involved. Yeah, a little bit of neck hole between the 11 there and the 16.
He just comes back and collects a 22 truck.
Yeah, you see Beach getting in there, John Barry going to the inside.
Yeah, a lot of guys. Gonna,
yeah, they had 11, and then Bobby gets clipped, and look at this. I mean, he is heading Eric McClure style down to that inside wall.
14 hit.
Oh, wow,
hit
he hit hard.
Hard.
Oh.
Up in the air.
Oh, 15 is up in the air. Oh, 15 went upside down.
I hope
upside
he's
down,
okay.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
Lowe's just freaking out, didn't know what to do there.
Oh, and look at Cody. Oh my
goodness. Oh, he just gets around. I don't know if he hit or not. And there goes the 15, goes back on all four wheels, almost goes back over again.
14.
You got to remember, that 15 truck was going at least like 130 while flipping like that. It looks like they're going about 20. Just from the angle.
From the Goodyear blimp, you're going to see, watch that white number 16 and the red, black and white 11.
Yeah, I think the 16 comes down here and it's going to turn the 11.
Just ever so slightly. And yep, you see there.
Yep.
Just one of those racing deals where the 11, I mean, the 15 comes down and the 11 comes up. Man.
But see that, you know. The 16, he gets in the wall right there, but the 19 is going to make it through. Oh, Cody Lamas just was about to get by and gets clipped. But
Nick Notra barely got past that wreck.
Nick somehow.
Look at the 24 also got through it.
Dude, 15 upside down.
Oh, who is that? Stuart Redman come in there, hits Bobby really hard.
Yeah, we see a couple of drivers here just say YOLO and go through that.
Yeah, and then you see the 15 still flipping upside down. Wild ride here.
I hope they're okay.
Yeah.
Just going to onboard her with Bobby Zielinski.
Oh, yeah, this is... Oh, look at this.
This is going to be a hard hit. Oh, damn.
And then he's going to hit crash. Again by Stuart Red. Oh, my goodness. Yep. Talladega.
Yeah, onboard the
see
four
from
car.
John Barry's view.
He hit in the inside wall pretty hard, too. Watch this.
Ooh, man, back then.
Yep,
really
yep.
hard. I think I hit by 11 there in the end as well.
This is on board with, believe, Ariadne. Yep.
Just out of nowhere, just gets hit.
Car goes
for the ride,
side.
Man.
Yeah, he almost slipped over as well.
A lot of really hard hits in this wreck.
Mm.
Oh, this is going to be good on board.
This will be great.
SpongeBob.
Hang on, folks. It's going to be a wild one. Oh, damn.
Wow.
Plankton struck again.
see that SpongeBob truck got up on the on his nose. He went for a wild ride.
Well, this will be a good view.
Now this is way behind the pack.
See how he drives for his wreck here.
Yeah, you see.
Can't
the
really
smoke.
See much.
Yeah, lifts up, lifts off the gas, but does a great job. Yeah,
see,
nice job.
I mean, seeing he just kind of YOLO through it, like I said earlier. He just.
Well, boys, here we go. About to go green again.
Yep, track's all cleaned up. 8 laps complete here. Your leader is Ryan Marin and Nick Northrup on his outside. Pace car is going to be pulling off here. And restart number one.
Yeah, several guys are going to use their resets here. They got, most of them will have two more left.
Yeah, like we said earlier, everybody does have three resets. So if you get in a wreck, it's not that big of a deal. But still got to try to take care of your truck and make it to the end. Green flag is out. And you see Marcus and the two already making it three wide.
That Browser's Mobile trying to make it three wide, make gain a couple positions.
Yeah, the car's also sponsored by Pornhub. It's a pretty good looking car considering what it's sponsored by. Or truck.
That's a new sponsor here in the Camp Pro Truck Series. No, happy to have them in the sport.
And that's all I want to say about that.
Yep.
I mean, anyway, here we go. We got Northrup. Yep. What better guy to have than with a Black Mamba? I mean, but go ahead, guys.
And we're side by side for the lead. Nick Northrup getting a push from Stuart Redmond. Bobby Chaney pushing Ryan Mayer on the inside. Then Matt Simpson up there.
And we're already three wide.
Yeah, that didn't take long.
Cody Lamas leading that line up there.
The number one truck in the soccer hole there.
Yeah, Marcus jumps to the inside. They're going to go
make it
four
wide.
Somebody's sideways
Benny.
Back there. Man.
Ready for freeze on paper. And there's a lot of really
here we go again.
Man.
What a crash.
What was that about? 92
Looks
and
like
5.
Hunter Combs and Nick Osipek involved in this one. 10 laps in, caution number 2 already.
We'll be building a lot of
coffins there. Yeah. And you see here it looks like
I think the outside lane came down.
Beach might have
came
down a
little 92.
Bit.
That was a hard hit.
Yeah, that's incredible. Yeah, let's see here. This might be a better angle. Look at the, you see the
Beach.
22 there, the last car on the third lane.
He's following, I believe, Cody Lamas there. And
oh, yeah, he just kind of turns down into Nick there, and then, you know, the contact.
It's just one of those racing deals. You saw the 5 kind of come up a little bit, but, you know, Beach trying to push the 48 truck, and that's the result.
And, you know, it might not look, you know, that hard, but, you know, these guys all in this pack, the side drafting and all these cars move, move around a lot, and, you know, so, here we are on board.
This is Hunter Combs.
Oh, yeah, this is Hunter, and, yep, hard.
Man, he's wondering what the hell just happened. Just grinding along.
You're spinning out there, almost breakdancing on that truck.
And then he's just gonna sit there. Well, see if we can get a few more laps in here. Maybe these guys will calm down. Had a couple of pretty nasty crashes to start this race. 13 laps complete. Ryan Marin and now Stuart Redmond on the front row with him. Then we got Freddie De La Rosa, Matt Simpson, and then John Bear round out your top 5. Green flag about to come back in the air.
Wait for it. It's taking a while for the green flag.
Yeah, that's start finish line at the end of the trial here, not like most tracks where it's in the center. Green flag.
We're already three wide again.
And oh my goodness, they almost had some contact already.
See everybody being really aggressive and they're using the three resets as a cushion, you know, and just having it makes for some exciting racing, but we also see these big ass wrecks.
Yeah, these guys they won't have many resets here much longer if they keep racing the way they are.
Yeah, these trucks they just get such a huge run when they're, you know, behind the cars in the draft. You know, sometimes they don't have anywhere to go with it except into the truck.
Oh man, there's a lot of chopping
already.
Really tight.
Four wide again.
Nope, this ain't good.
How are they not wrecking?
They somehow keep it together.
Yeah, look at this pack of trucks and they're just all over the damn place.
What a sight this is.
These fans. Yeah, these fans seeing some great action, and still Ryan Marin and Stuart Redmond side by side for the lead.
Four cars going straight to the back. That outside line is completely just died on them.
And you see Freddie pushing Ryan all the way around the bottom of the racetrack, shortest way around. That's where I'd want to be.
Yeah, That bottom line can get stacked up a lot, though, as you see the middle line working really good so far this race.
We see that a 17 truck on the outside without a sponsor, but he's making some way to the front there, trying to impress some of these people.
Yeah, so that's the great thing about Talladega.
You can have any truck in the field and still have a shot to the win. And I actually spoke to Scrucci this morning, and I asked him, man, how you planning on winning this race without a sponsor? And he said, well, that's the best thing we can do, winning and show them that we don't need no support from nobody to win, because we have the determination and discipline to do it. So let's see what these guys do.
Yeah, most definitely.
Very well said.
Yeah, there's a lot of some really iffy moves going on right now in the pack.
Yeah, you see that middle lane, you know, maintaining, but now there's a third lane starting to come with Derek Bordeaux and Marcus Richardson up there in the third lane.
Man, three wide again.
Yeah, you can see that middle lane just works very well.
Yeah,
just gotta get the right push.
That third lane is actually, they seem to be coming up here too. They got a pretty nice run on the outside.
Yeah, this is definitely the best drafting package iRacing has had in a long, long time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is good stuff right here, boys.
Yeah, the new bill was just last week, and we so glad this is the drafting model now. Just
3x3 and 4x1
again. See, the mighty Marcus making it 4x there in the middle.
No. Yep,
it came up.
Here we go.
22.
Oh, upside down on Moses Beach.
What a crash.
And another massive accident here on the back straightaway at Talladega.
That was not pretty for that 22, and he's still driving. He got hit right on the roof.
I believe that's the second crash that 22 has been in, so, you know, three resets, might be down to just one now.
All right, let's take a look at the replay here. We see four wide back here. See what caused the contact here. Marcus came up a little bit. I don't know. Did he get it like net coded by somebody or what?
Derek could have came down a little bit. It was really close.
Yeah, we need to see a better angle. But that 22.
Oh,
yikes.
Man.
That's one of the worst crashes I've seen. Wow. Like, he goes into the 11 truck. Like, I've never seen anything like that in my life.
Ariadne had a sight.
See the 5 truck right there.
Look at the fence. They're not taking their eyes off all strokes. That's for
okay,
sure.
Here we go.
Yeah, here's a better angle. You see Marcus 4 wide and...
I didn't even really cause the wreck. It was behind them.
Yeah, and them getting together kind of, you know, hit him a little bit. But it looked like contact between Derek and somebody on the inside.
Had to take another look at it there. But it just kind of looked like just way too many cars were too close to a spot. Ooh, looks like the 22.
Maybe the 20.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my.
It's kind of really hard to pin blame on anyone that right. It just seems like there's too many people in too small a spot.
Just a pack racing incident. Oh, watch this. Wow.
So yeah, that's a product of this kind of draft package now. It's really fun. Really fun to watch. But you also see stuff like that happen more often.
Pits will be open.
Yeah, the pits will be open. We haven't seen much action now, but you know, these guys do got to get fuel at least once in this race. So
see Marcus Richardson leading them
Chevy there.
Mhm. I heard he had Rachel Starr in his pit box here earlier today cheering him on.
See a couple people stay out.
54 misses pit a little bit. And so did the 4.
Yep. And Marcus Richardson won the race off pit road. Derek Bordeaux comes off second.
I tell them, there's some of these guys, I don't think they have that many resets left. There might be guys who might be down to 1.
Yeah. I know for sure that 22. I've seen the 24 sideways a couple times.
Another thing about this new draft package, you know, nobody in this race is used to it. It just came out. There's never really been a draft package like this before. This awesome. So, just being a little too aggressive right now. See what happens next. Let's see if they keep up the aggressiveness.
Restart number 3. We're not even halfway yet, but still the same. 17 of Stu Redman, the unsponsored truck, there leading this race with Ryan Marin on his outside. Another unsponsored truck in third, Matt Simpson. Here we go again.
Yeah. Just to talk about the draft package, like, the draft model they had before this was complete 180 of what they got now.
Yeah. Well, and we thought they'd calmed down their 3-1 already.
Brace has no chill.
See, Marcus Richardson and that Pornhub Chevrolet leading them on the outside.
It looks like he might be all by himself up there. No, he's got Derek up there with him.
Yeah, he's got some help.
Oh, now, yep, they're going to try to make... No.
I'm seeing them starting to fan out here in an early 3-1. Might be making a 4-1. Here comes Jared Darling all the way up the track.
Jared Darling, oh, man. What a ballsy move.
Yeah, that middle lane has a lot of help right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think overall, I think the middle lane probably is the quickest out of the lines.
As we see, Ryan Marin struggling four wide again.
4 wide again.
Ooh. Looks like that number one truck is in the sucker hole.
Back in turn one, see how they get through this corner.
Well, Matt's on the apron. Here we go again.
More problems.
See Marcus Richardson and
Paul. Oh, we got one.
Upside
down.
Someone's upside down.
Oh,
we got
more problems.
Oh, they're wrecking
more
again.
Cars.
Oh,
oh
no.
The 33 is barreling down the back straightaway.
Oh, no.
Silent,
we need more coffins.
Oh, no.
A horrible ride.
Order more.
Oh, and probably
so
can't
that might
steer.
Have been a bigger risk.
Oh, we had two separate accidents here.
Let's take a look at the first one, though. It looks like... Watch the two.
See, Marcus
is
looking
like 54
and
one.
Nick
54
into
one, into make
Freddy.
Contact.
Yep.
And then Lux.
54 kind of slides up a little bit there, and...
Oh, man. One takes a hard shot.
Yeah,
the
Freddy, and he is gonna... He's. Oh, my gosh, he's on top of cars.
Turn down for what?
Now, I believe what happened here, the caution came out. Ooh, the 33 just came up.
Oh, Bobby. And 33 makes some contact.
And this is just taking out everybody.
Nick Northam missing another wreck.
Yeah, causes the one 10 seconds ago and then makes it through that one.
And the 33 just
then,
nails the outside wall.
Just hits the wall with that, you know, weird angle, then gets hit.
And the car just starts to barrel roll.
Look at that. End over end, side over side.
I think we've had a flip just about every wreck today.
A flip or a near flip.
Yeah.
I mean, this truck, they just love to flip. And it's amazing how far the technology has come. Because you're going to see this guy just flip and then he just drive off like nothing happened.
Yeah.
Man, these iRacing trucks are durable.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I would say they're built forked up, but there's no actual forks.
Yeah, I would say the 54 just kind of slipped a little bit.
Damn,
man, look at Freddy.
What a crash.
I hope he's okay.
That's incredible.
We need more coffins.
I'm bored here with, yeah.
No, this is Freddy, and and just goes upside down.
My God,
bring it for Dale?
Giving me a headache. Well, good thing these boys got some resets.
I think this is on board Marcus Richardson here. He gets turned. Actually, he does a well of a job not to wreck the thing more than what he did.
And he sees the wreck up there. Oh, I gotta make it through another one.
He just goes wide open to it.
Holy! Oh, he's fancy. Oh, he's such a.
Oh, my. Here's Bobby Chaney's view.
And misses this. The first wreck. And here's the second wreck.
He's like, God damn, I gotta make it through another one.
Man, look at that driving for that.
Working that steering wheel.
Yeah, good thing there's a lot of runoff area down there on the back straightaway.
That's an interesting pacing there. We'll be seeing ya.
No, we'll be seeing you in the air again. Does he get through it? Wow.
Wow, Nick getting through that wreck. I believe we're on board with Nick there.
And this is on board with the 33. This is going to be a wild ride. Yeah, he just turns up the racetrack in the middle of the corner. I'm not sure if something happened or he got hit.
And then watch this. Ground sky.
And it finally
but
stops.
He can drive off the engine.
He just lands, put another arm and drive off.
Let's see, with Bon Jovi here, going into one, and there's contact. This gets to the apron.
Oh, there's Marcus.
Oh, wow.
And there's another wreck in front of him.
You can see Marcus, he just he's going.
Yeah, you see freaking Bon Jerry right here just taking his time, getting through the wreck, and
now this happens under caution here. I don't know why, but 22 is just going to turn into 17. Is going to
oh,
turn
no.
later.
Huh.
Well, he hung on to it.
Wow. What was that all about, guys?
Had to be wondering. Mm-hmm.
We'll be seeing you.
Yeah, and then now he's just going to bring it back to the road.
Yeah, he's all theory. He's not going to lose anything. But
I mean,
that was...
I guess that's one way to take the lead.
Yeah, just break the guy under caution.
Well, and they're going to, you know, he's going to stay the leader.
All right, I guess no penalty for that.
We got Beach and Nick Northrup leading. The green field's kind of weirdly lined up right now.
Yeah, most of the field's trying to catch back up.
Yeah. You might see, three pretty big crashes now. We're just about halfway. This field's a little spread out right now, so we'll see what happens here.
Going back to green, we get the 54 Nick Northrup going to push from the 4 car. Or was going to push from the 4 car.
I mean, you can just see how fast that 19 just sucks up to that 22. I mean, look at that. He runs right in the back of him. The runs these guys get are just incredible.
That 19 has to make sure... hold his line correctly when pushing this guy. We, like you said earlier, had some criticism from other drivers.
Yeah.
He's in a stall spot right here because you can't really see anything but the rear end of the truck in front of you. So if
yeah.
it was tough
yeah.
for him to hold a line in front, it's going to be even tougher now.
Yeah, when you're pushing the car in front of you and you're on a bomb line, you can't have a hard time telling like where the actual apron is in the track.
You just can't see going into the corner. You just kind of have to guess or look. Kind of swerve out to look, you know.
It's definitely a lot harder than it looks, guys. Yeah, you see, this is the most spread out and calm we have seen this race.
You have to also think, there's been a lot of wrecks and a lot of people that probably got one or maybe don't even have any reasons for this one. So they're taking it easy.
We got Beach lead the field here. Spun the 17 under caution. He's already back up.
And
Sonny's
already back up here.
Only got two on the outside. That bottom line with the more cars.
He just threw a block on the 54. That's going to cost him. Almost caused a wreck.
Yikes. Come on, guys.
And these guys are driving really aggressively.
It's going to hand the lead over to Ryan Marin now with Stewart.
Here comes Stewart.
Stewart and the 17, I'm really, really impressed with those guys. I mean, he's just been a factor all race.
Yes.
Yeah, you gotta think that team has probably the worst equipment out of all these teams. There's no sponsors on that thing.
It looks like the line is
stopping
up. Oh, he's
gonna go up high. Wow. What a risky move right there. They are now back to the 3-wide race that we've been seeing all day, and now he's gonna be by himself.
Yeah, he had the 4 push him, the 4 just bailed on him. There's a 22 up to the lead. Looks like Nick Dutch trying to look on the inside there, but there was no room there.
Wow,
look
at the run the 33 and the 15 have there.
Here comes the back half. There's a group of 4 led by Marcus Richardson.
Yep, you can just see how easy it is to gain that ground back up from the draft.
Yeah, those guys are running single file back here, trying to get back up to this lead group. Now you got the 4 car, he'll be leaning outside the line here. Yeah, push back from the 17.
See Hunter Combs up there in 4th. This is the highest we've seen that truck. Trying to get up there and get a taste of the lead.
Yeah, I believe he was involved in the second caution of the day.
Yep. Yeah, with Nick Osipek there. See Beach still continuing to lead. Ryan Marin almost clipping the apron there a little bit.
There's a lot of drivers there, and they're just playing it smart right now. Like the SpongeBob truck of Jared Darling. He's been taking it easy this race. I spoke to his crew this morning actually, and they just wanted to put up a good show, score some points, and get out of here with a truck in one piece. So good for them.
you know, the kids in the grandstands were for that paint scheme, that truck, so. Probably got a lot of fans. See, the 11 there has some damage on the back end there, but, you know, the draft, you can have some damage, you can still keep up.
Yeah, actually, I believe the 22 might have some front end damage as well, but I can't tell if that's actually the car or he's got some, just the paint scheme.
This is the closest. John Barry looked for the lead here on the outside with Stuart Revan, who has shown some great speed all race so far, pushing him.
Man, that inside line, they're kind of all over the place right now. Here comes the Fords trying to take the lead on the outside here.
We have a low setback down there. Get up to speed.
We see Jim Berry making a good effort on the outside, and that's one thing about these trucks. It's more about how many trucks you have on one line that'll make the speed difference as opposed to how big you can draft. So we see we have a good amount of trucks there on the outside. Four trucks.
We have about four cars up there. It looks like they're a little bit more better organized than the cars on the inside, or trucks inside line.
Pretty calm right now. I mean, they are still double file, but compared to what we've seen, you know, as John Barry looks for the lead here, and he might have led that lap.
It's still really tight side by side up here, like trying to pinch him down, trying to get a side wrap off of him.
Yep.
Here. However, that one, like, even though they're running side by side, that group behind them that's running single file was running single file, trying to run single file. They're not really gaining much ground on them.
See Femi in that 16. Might be losing the pack just a little bit. He could be the bridge to, you know, bring those four cars up to the main pack.
Yeah, once that group behind them catches them, they should be able to propel them back up into this group.
That's 17 all over the four, pushing them all the way around this racetrack on that outside line. Can't quite clear the bottom lane, but they are hanging it tough.
You gotta wonder, what is the four Aveline truck gonna do if he gets clear of this 22? Is he gonna leave the 17? Or is he gonna stay with them and try to bring the 17 with him to get on the bottom line?
You know, you say at Talladega, everybody, you know, everyone has a chance to win, but we see that the 17 all race has had a lot of speed, and I would want to stay with that 17 truck, I think.
And it seems like the outside line is a little bit quicker down the straightaways and come off the corners, but through the corners, this, you know, inside line has got the better, like, has a shorter way around.
Oh, yeah, you get a big run when you're in the middle, or especially at the high line, off the corner, you get a giant run down the straightaways. And that's what makes it so good for making passes going into the corner or in the middle of the straightaway, just getting that big run and just hopping down to the bottom.
You can see here, for example, John Berry gets that big run off the high side.
Oh, there's some contact. Oh my goodness.
Is he okay?
Murray Free was up on the side.
That was just going down the straightaway too, and wow.
That was very fast. Wow, we gotta see that replay.
Unbelievable.
Fifth caution of the day.
From what I've seen, Northrop just turned up for what and killed here, Matt.
Yeah, he just
wow. Oh wow.
15 took
some damage.
Yep, and oh
no.
Poor guy.
Yeah. Yeah, no, maybe did the 19 get in the 54?
Let's see here, like, there's about.
He might have got sandwiched here. He was sandwich action.
Yeah, because he's getting pushed by the 19 that's pushed him into the 22, and actually that turns him up to racetrack.
Yeah, it might have, and then the 33 just. Oh my goodness.
You see that 15 hit him and just lifts the truck on its side.
Yeah, SpongeBob just lifted him up in the air and hit that wall. Nick spin to the inside. Strange wreck.
Mm-hmm.
What a crash.
Here you see a spinning 48 truck. Obviously at that 33, and this looks going to be like a four truck accident here.
That 48 car, I mean, that 48 truck, I tell you what, it's spinning every wreck.
Oh damn, man! There's gonna be some damage to that car.
Absolutely nowhere to go.
It's a good job of not spinning.
Oh, time for another restart here. We've got the group. Like, looks like the pack's a little bit better organized than it was before.
By the way, just getting word that that record there for Matt Simpson, that actually he used all of his resets, and he is done for the day.
Man, that sucks for him. Having a great run.
Just
here we go, the green
wrong
flag
place,
out.
Wrong time, every time. But, yep, green flag is out. And we got John Barry leading him into turn number one. Beach on the outside.
Beach getting a great push from Ryan Marin right now. But they got a little disconnected there.
Gonna side draft there, the number four trucker, John Barry.
Yeah. Yeah, the 4 and 17, they were on the outside line the whole time, but now they're in the inside line. See how they do this time.
Also want to report that the 24 of Bobby Chaney and the 11 of Ariadne also behind the wall from crash damage.
Free one. Here comes the dart.
Derek Berto and Marcus Richardson coming to the, coming to the front.
Looks like he got a little sideways, but he's going to save it and just get out of the way and does a good job of keeping it down out of everybody's way. You see Derek Berto and Marcus Richardson on the outside. Beach in the middle all by himself.
And the 22 has lost his help.
Yeah, they got a nice run on the outside here. Femi going up there with him.
The Dart and Marcus have worked together in SRA plate races and done a very good job. I wouldn't be surprised if they take the lead here.
Now you see Beach got some help from Nick Northrup in the middle, and they are 3x3 for the lead.
Yeah, it was chilled here for a little bit, but they're back to 3 wide action.
I think where this field runs into trouble is when it's 4 wide. There's room for it. It's just can't make a mistake. No one can make a mistake when you're 4 wide. And every time we've been 4 wide, we've made mistakes here. So let's see if these guys can hold this 3 wide together for a while. This is really entertaining to watch.
Yeah, 3 wide around here is pretty easy. 4 wide is where we're running into problems.
Yeah, you can see there's a lot of room in between the trucks still when they're 3 wide. Less than 20 laps to go, guys.
Man, if I was back in, I don't know, a few cars back of this 3 wide, I'd be moving up and try to get with one of those people on the outside, you know? Get
a line
going.
But some of these guys might not have any more resets, so they're just trying to, you know, take it easy right now and get to the end.
That's right.
Yeah, we are starting to run out of laps here. We only got like around 18, 17 laps to go here.
Yeah.
We're still 3 wide up here front.
This is fantastic, guys. Look at this.
3x3x3. What a fantastic job,
this
guys.
This 13 truck should have a good run off the corner.
Oh, yeah, look at him. He gets a big drive off the turn number 4.
Oh, yeah.
22 has the 4 clear. Oh, and the 17 is going to dip on the 4.
Wow, he's going to leave the 4.
He's going to go with his SRA counterparts.
Yep.
And then back to 2 wide. But he doesn't have a partner.
Now I see Ryan Marin looking to the help the 4 get back up there for the lead. And then now it's double wide. Nick going to the inside of Beach.
I think he tried to push him, and Beach just kind of went up the track and didn't want to.
I think
Marcus
might
like
got
scraping
the
wall there.
Ooh, wait.
Oh, he has all movement around
there.
Oh,
back boy.
Here.
It's not good.
Nice
54
Derek,
here.
Yeah,
Darren Bordeaux
leading, but these guys are going to do that big run on him. Here comes Nick Northrup with Beach to the outside.
Oh, Marcus looking in.
Oh,
he turns to 19. 19 saves it, but no, comes back across the racetrack, and cars are around. And caution will be
out
blows. Here. Oh, my God.
Oh,
he Cody Llamas again.
Just in the wrong place at the wrong time once again. It looked like Marcus just basically turned the 19.
Let's see what happened here.
Take a look at a replay. Okay, here we go. Looks like we get the 19. 19 is moving up a little bit here. 19 comes back down. Marcus makes a really abrupt move. Looked like he was trying to get to the inside of 19, and this turns him.
You know, I think Marcus might have thought the 19 was going up high, so that he was making his move, and then the 19 went back down.
Oh, when you see 19 come back up, clip the 14.
Oh my,
clip
look at
the
Freddy Agricultural Racing back there. Makes
and then
through,
Llamas just, look at that, it's out of nowhere, it's an 18 truck and clips him just a little bit. Shouldn't be too much damage on that truck there. So hopefully he's still, you know, that's just bad luck for that 48.
He has to be careful with that radiator. He might have some engine problems there.
Oh, you saw the one of Freddy get loose and just go through the grass.
Look at that. Nice job, though.
Oh! Wow.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm born with Freddy.
Yeah, watch this.
Oh, he actually gets hit from behind.
Oh, that's what happened. He gets hit from behind.
Man, that's some driving right there. Now there's another car down there that's spinning.
Corner of his eye, sees us in the car spinning. Nope. Alright, man, we're gonna go green with 13 to go.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like I said, the number 48, Cody Lama's not here anymore.
That could have resulted in engine damage. That, you know. Well, we got 15 trucks remaining. Any one of these 15 trucks can win this thing. It should be exciting. Here we go.
Green flag's coming back in our way.
Coming here to 10 laps to go, so it's gonna pick up here pretty soon.
You won't see anybody ride now. It's time to go. Gotta get position yourself and get ready for this. This is gonna be nuts.
Yeah, there's trying to make it free wide back there again.
Already, like Derek Bordeaux with can't really tell who that is behind him. Oh, he's him.
Oh, here, yep, here we go.
There goes Freddy and Marcus to the outside.
Now, a lot of movement back there. Tell me, some team has been up here. For most of this race, so it's been 54.
Everyone just trying to get some good position.
You see Bobby Zelensky there on the inside with John Berry, working his way back up to the front.
The two Hamlin cars working together.
Yeah.
The 20 hasn't been up here since took that hard hit
in
lap 5.
You see our pole sitter there right behind him in that number 14 car, working his way back up. Everybody just trying to get there. You see Hunter Combs back there.
Ooh.
He might be... Oh, contact a little bit. Marcus to the way outside. Bobby Slinsky up high.
See a lot of guys here throwing blocks and trying to
block the drone. Yep, trying to decide which line is moving and switching back and forth. Femi pushing Stuart Redman off turn number 4.
About double foul now for the first 8 positions.
Oh.
Wow, way up to that 10 laps to go. Way up to the outside.
De La Rosa tried to get in front of that 2 truck, and then there's just not enough time to get in front of him.
These guys are getting desperate here. Blocking runs left and right. So they just want to get that opportunity. As we see the number 17 truck here taking the lead.
They got a nice run. They got disconnected on the bottom. Here comes. Yeah, they got a nice run on that outside.
The 17 is 17 stabbers. He come down. He's gonna go down.
Got a 3-car push. We had a 3-car push going on, and that, like I said earlier, sometimes you just gotta leave your partner and just go down to that bottom line, because that's still where you want to be.
And now we start to see a third lane on the outside. There are 3 cars up there. Let's see if they can do anything.
Yeah, Jared and Marcus are making some headway up there on the high line.
Yeah, look at that.
Still half high side for the lead, and been saying that a lot. No one's been up front single foul at all during the race.
Man, this is intense right here with 9 laps
to go.
Right
here, this is 3 wide, trying to go for the lead. Look at the run the third lane has.
And they're there.
Wow.
Inside line starting to pull back up a little bit here.
Look at this. Whew, coming to 8 to go.
Yeah, I don't see this lasting much longer.
Boys, I'm on my toes right now.
Hey man, this is... Oh, and Olaf's gonna come down.
Femi comes down barely in front of the 17.
If he had the room, he did come down now.
Oh,
he's
here?
Actually,
here comes
now he's
17.
Going back to the outside.
That 17's not coming outside.
He wants to lead. And all this scrambling is going to give the 15
wide.
And 2 a really good opportunity to get in front of these bottom lanes.
Yeah, but they only got 2 up there.
Yeah, that seemed like the middle line seems like it's the quickest way around. But it's like no one, like it's really hard to actually get around the leader and clear them.
Looks like the 15 and 2 are gonna.
There's 17 that's those back down
to
the bottom.
Stewart back to the bottom. Now Bobby leads the middle lane with Freddy behind him.
See Gucci in the hub here. I'm trying to go for the lead. See what happens.
Looks like the 4 car might be jumping up to the outside line, and looks like he does.
See that number 1 truck.
Look at that big
stuck
run
right
to
the
big out. Drive. Freddy all over the back of Bobby in the 20. Side by side for the lead, Bobby Zielinski, Stuart Redman. Marcus on the back bumper of John Barry now.
Yeah, that middle line getting some steam.
We got about 12 trucks in this lead draft. Coming to 6 to go, guys.
Marcus
is going for the middle.
Too close. He's going to get what he wants. He wanted
Revan,
the middle, and he's going
to
get it.
Revan does a nice job of moving up to avoid disaster there. 6 to go. Will these guys make it back? I don't see it.
No, I don't think so. Outside line is still holding tough, though.
The pushing
number
is going
to
get
truck. The number
the
one truck still stuck to the rear bumper of that 22 truck. You got to think, 20 truck, I'm sorry. Got to think that he's overheating by this point.
Well, coming to the end, you don't worry about that. You just gotta want to get that win.
There's Marcus in the 2 truck. He's right there, third in line on the outside.
Ooh,
oh, that's close right there. Yeah, Marcus looking for the middle again. Oh my!
No fingers room for it. Oh, you
saw it. Oh, and that's gonna. Wow.
He keeps going for these holes. There's just no hole there.
5 to go.
Truck's just too big to go in those holes, Marcus.
Yeah, you want to think that Marcus is an expert opening holes, but they just watched the hole right
now. Well, he is sponsored by Pornhub, so.
On to the racing boys.
Anyway,
we
saw Bobby and them had a good run on the outside when they got broke up on the bottom, but there just wasn't enough trucks to get that run, and now the bottom pulls back. Oh, Stewart goes to the outside.
High.
Femi looking for the lead. Interesting move there. Marcus wants to go make it 3 wide, but he's got no help. But John Barry looking there, trying to get up to there.
Okay, we're getting a point now. If a caution comes out, that's going to be the end of the race.
Yep, 4 to go, guys. 4 to go. 12 trucks.
Yeah, see how these drivers react to, you don't want a wreck, it'll end the race. You know, the 2 leaders up here and 2 on the 2 leaders of the lines, just trying to stay ahead of each other just in case.
Yeah.
Tell them the 17 has done a really good job staying up there.
That unsponsored truck trying to get that win, that would be just an incredible story.
And really
that
good push
line.
Down.
Oh,
there's
wow.
Freddy sideways down the backstretch. He saves it. They're still going. 3 wide.
And there goes the 17. He's pulling up and a little bit of a lead here.
Stewart could have cleared him, but he staying with the 20. Side by side still. Nick Northrup pushing Femi. 3 to go coming here.
Freddy's right back up there on that 20. Looks like he's going to make a move to the outside, but oh, Marcus ain't
Marcus
go with
doesn't
him.
Go with him, and they're coming up a lap truck here of Derek Bordeaux. He was not too long ago was with these
his
guys.
His ain't loyal.
Well, it looks like the 13 should stay up out of the way, and he is.
Yes, he will. Well, this is going to come right down to no line is getting the advantage. They're just still side by side. They've been side by side like this since the restart. Stewart back to the bottom. Nice move there. Bobby gonna have Marcus on his bumper now.
Oh, 20, making some moves.
Reacted to the 17, kind of moving up there.
We was on 3 wide back there again, or not.
Coming to 2 laps to go. 2 to go at Talladega.
Yeah, if a car comes out now, this race is over. So this
Bobby,
is kind of a ticking
Bobby's
time
Bobby's got Marcus
here.
Pushing, and they got a nice run through the tri-oval. And remember, the start finish line way down here. It might come down to the very end, to the tri-oval.
Bobby Zielinski coming up.
Third lane trying again.
They're going to have a big run off of this turn.
Down the back straightaway. The white flag will be waving next. It's Stewart and Bobby side by side.
We see that third lane trying to build some momentum here to come to the
Freddy,
outside.
Freddy and John Barry looking to the outside.
Nick no trouble looking. Nope.
Oh, he
went
goes
back
low.
To the inside.
They're gonna
Looks
to,
like Marcus is going to try to get
gonna,
in front of that.
They're going to block that third lane, or the third lane might have a run here. Come to the
white
Finney's
boys.
Looking
at
the,
oh,
no,
block.
Oh, no. Massive
oh, man. No.
What a crap.
Race is over.
Oh, it's not over. Who got through it?
Man, that's a shame. That is a shame. That was
coming to the white flag.
And I think Nick Notrip and Nathan Duenas were the only ones who made it through the wreck.
These are the only two to make it through the wreck.
And the caution did fly. It was not one lap to go yet. Got
so
that
the
line. The start finish line is just past the tri-oval. So no
look
caution.
Look at the pace car trying to get back up there.
I think
wow.
That gives the 54 the win. There are only two cars got through that.
Can you believe? Look, yeah, look at these trucks coming up, smoking.
Yeah, everybody else was in wreck.
They're just trying to. They think it's a good top five.
I mean, that was awesome racing, but it's a shame that we didn't get to end under green.
Oh my gosh, I don't know who that was, but we believe it might have been that unsponsored truck that took an unbelievable ride, went way up in the air.
I think the whole field went underneath of them.
I mean,
man, going from first to worst. I want to see what happened. I think.
Yeah, I was too busy watching the third lane come up, and all of a sudden looks like Femi and Stewart got together. But
yeah, if I remember right, I think the 16 went to make a move, and the 17 went to block, and there was just
I mean, this is
into the
coming to the white flag. Look at all these trucks trying to make it to the finish.
Yeah, I got the four car putting off a lot of smoke. Actually, they're scoring four in second place.
They are
going to
give the 4 second.
Yeah, it looks like the five is going to push the 20 to line 20 inch in blue.
I know we'll see on the replay, but Nick had to, had to be in the right place at the right time. And he will win here at Talladega under caution flag for the FTRL 250K. Nick Northrup, his first win in a full throttle race.
The inaugural FTRL iRacing race, too.
Our first ever race on iRacing goes to Nick. Now, here we go. Let's see what happened.
Yeah, I believe Finney's going to try and make a run to the outside here. He's going to try and make a pass, and the 17 is going to block. And I think right here
they're
they
hooked.
Get hooked.
They're hooked.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, my.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
The whole field goes underneath the 17.
Everybody drove under that 17. Look at Nick. The only car. Truck, sorry.
We see Femi here trying to make a move to the outside.
I think he is,
but
Nick, they got hooked there. But
yeah.
He went to make a move, and the 17 just
Stewart
didn't know
blocked.
How to block it. He tried blocking, but there was a car there, and just turned himself. You see all that money they were gonna get help that team.
All
just
that
boom out the
yeah,
window.
Now that's done there.
They might not even do the race next week.
Man,
yeah, that 17 truck is destroyed.
Yeah, that 17 took off like a rocket ship there.
Yeah,
that's unbelievable.
Look at this.
Yeah, I mean, the third. Yeah, Timmy's going up really high.
Nick was just in the right place at the right time there. Look at that. Oh, my. Look, every single truck is going underneath that 17.
I think the 18 got through this unscathed.
Well, the 18. Yeah, look at this.
Yeah, 18.
Closing his eyes should probably just.
I have no idea how the 18 made it through that.
It's a shame to see all these trucks get tore up so close to the finish.
This
is live, yeah. Speed, here we go.
Wow, that's so
that
here
is
comes the 18 is
incredible.
I don't even
incredible.
Know how. 18 was the only person who was behind the wreck that made it through it.
Yeah. Unbelievable. From the Goodyear blimp here. You see Femi already on the outside, and Stewart's moving up. You can see right there.
Yep. What a view from the TK Bradco blimp.
And then, yeah, look at Nathan. Get through that. Oh, Derek almost made it.
Yeah,
just
the 13
oh,
went
my
for the same
goodness.
Gap and just killed the wall. He got clipped in the right rear quarter panel.
That is crazy how Nathan made it through it.
See that onboard here.
Look at
look
at the 17 flying! And, wow.
He closed his eyes. Just kept his foot in it. They went right through it. Nice.
And you see Femi move. Yeah, it does look like the 17 did put a little block on it. Then the carnage.
Everybody, except them two.
Oh,
man!
Oh my goodness!
This still crashing. What a free for all.
But he's the leader.
Oh,
let's watch
no.
the steering wheel here.
Well, watch the steering wheel.
He turned right just a little bit, but he got hooked right away, and...
Yeah, you can see. Watch his hands. Yep, a little jerk to the right.
He got hooked early.
and then nothing you can do here, and then, I mean, wow.
For the ride.
Crowd, cement, sky, cement.
Look at all those cars just drive under him.
Ah, that laning was probably the worst part.
I've never seen anything like that in my life.
You just gotta give it to iRacing and the safety of these vehicles.
I'm more now bonus than
20 here.
Ah, he almost had it. He almost had it, made it through. Just got clipped at the last second when the when Femi came back down. Derek Bordeaux on board with him. Oh my.
Oh, he almost made it.
Yeah, he was trying to follow Nathan through there and just got clipped up on his side.
Yeah, all you can do in these wrecks at the end of the race is just keep your foot in it because, you know, there's all those cars. It's the only thing you can really do.
That is unbelievable. That's just what, wow.
Yeah, that's just incredible. Ain't that, Jared?
Oh my, yes. Look at those trucks.
Dang. Just spins everywhere. The one hit the pit wall.
Man.
Hopefully some picker members are okay down there.
Well, and look at this.
Look at that.
Coming, basically the checkered flag. I mean, wow.
Well, let's take a look at the final finishing results here.
Now you see Nick Northrup bringing home the checkered flag in the FTR 250K with John Barry second, Nathan Duanis third, Bobby Zlinski, Nick Osapek rounding out the top five.
Man, it's crazy. Nick Osapek, after running in the back all race, going to end up with a top five. Jared Darling going to get sixth place. Steven Ray in seventh, and the rest are a lap down. Could not make it to the flag.
Didn't make it to the checkered flag. Well, the first time FTRL moves over to iRacing, and guys, I don't know about you, but we saw an incredible show.
Yeah, it was incredible. That 17 truck really impressed me. Even though he couldn't pull it off there at the end, it's really a shame. But the way he flew, though, you gotta give it to iRacing. The safety on these trucks, you see this driver
that
he can wreck two or three times, and they're just able to go and go and go and race. So iRacing, good job with the safety of these vehicles.
Yeah, it was really, really entertaining to watch. A lot of three and sometimes four wide racing that didn't end well when they went four wide, but a lot of really, really hard fought, really close side by side racing.
Yeah, with time, these drivers will get better with this new awesome draft model and learn what they can and can't do, learn how much pull the draft really has, and you know, guess things better, estimate just the movement of everybody else. And so it was a very entertaining watch. So I don't know about you guys, it was fun to commentate as well.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And we appreciate you guys coming out, the fans. It was really, really good fun here in the booth.
Yeah, well, I want to thank everybody for watching this race. I hope you enjoyed it. We definitely, like we said, enjoyed commentating. I want to thank Revan, Freddie, Waffle, and Bobby for commentating with me. A lot of fun, and first iRacing race for this league, and hopefully we'll do some more in the future. It was a great race. Thanks for watching, and until next time.
Bye-bye.